Make it Sir Jaime, the Kingslayer, henceforth, Stannis said, frowning. Whatever else a man may be, he remains a knight. I don't know that we ought to call Robert my beloved brother either. He loved me no more than he had to, nor I him.
A harmless courtesy, your grace, Pylas said.
A lie. Take it out.
He glanced thoughtfully at Maester Pylas. The king caught the look.
Maester, perhaps you ought to get to your writing. The letter. What did your lords make of it, I wonder?
Stannis snorted.
Celtigar pronounced it admirable. If I showed him the contents of my privy, he would declare that admirable as well. The others bobbed their heads up and down like a flock of geese.
Lord Renly.
King Renly? Can that truly be you, Stannis?
Stannis frowned. Oh, well, should it be?
I did not come here to eat fruit.
Stannis was fuming.
But what does it matter? The boar got Robert, and I got Marjorie. You'll be pleased to know she came to me a maid. In your bed, she's like to die that way.
I'm not without mercy,
thundered he who was notoriously without mercy.
Single combat, tchah! The king snorted in derision. No doubt he mistook me for Robert.
Robert could piss in a cup and men would call it wine, but I offer them pure cold water, and they squint in suspicion and mutter to each other about how queer it tastes.
Stannis ground his teeth.
If someone said I had magicked myself into a boar to kill Robert, likely they would believe that as well. One day I may make you a lord, smuggler, if only to irk Celtigar and Florent. You will not thank me, though. It will mean you must suffer through these councils and feign interest in the braying of mules.
Why'd you have them, if they serve no purpose?
The mules love the sound of their own braying. Why else? And I need them to haul my cart. Oh, to be sure, once in a great while, some useful notion is put forward. But not today, I think. Let me tell you how it will go. Lord Valerian will urge me to storm the castle walls at first light. The young mules will think this a splendid notion. Estamont will favor settling down to starve them out. That might take a year, but old mules are patient. And Lord Caron and the others, who like to kick, will want to take up Sir Courtney's gauntlet and hazard all upon a single combat. Each one imagining he will be my champion and win undying fame. Salador Sand told me. Salador Sand thinks only of gold.
Stannis exploded. His head is full of dreams, of the treasure he fancies lies under the Red Keep.
So let us hear no more of Salador Sand.
The day I need military counsel from a Lycian brigand is the day I put off my crown and take the black.